Hey, what's up, y'all? So I am bringing you something completely different that we've never done on the Outdoor Solutions channel before, and that is with a muzzleloader. And this isn't just any regular old muzzleloader. This is a Gunwerks muzzleloader. The reason we're doing this, we, for the last 3 years now, actually this will be our third year, have been doing a field-to-table event in New Mexico for cow elk. Well, one of the units that we do it in is a muzzleloader only, actually muzzleloader archery primitive weapon. And another thing that has also happened in that particular unit, actually it's statewide, New Mexico no longer allows optics on muzzleloaders. So that creates another challenge. So here's the challenge that we've had, is convincing you all that a muzzleloader is relatively easy to use. And so a lot of people are like, oh man, I really want to do a cow elk field to table, but I want to do it with my rifle. I don't have a muzzleloader and I've never shot one before. So the purpose of this video is to show you how easy the guys at Gunwerks have made it. I've only played with this for just a little bit. I've done muzzleloader hunts in the past, but more with just a traditional Thompson Center type muzzleloader. I would not consider myself an expert, but I can't hit the broadside of a barn with one. So a few things on this muzzleloader. I'm not going to go into all the features. This is not a pitch for this particular muzzleloader, although it is a fantastic one. It is on a Remington 700 action. So you can see I actually have a bolt here. And so your ignition system or your primer, you're actually loading what would be like a cartridge, which is part of your ignition system. And I'll show you that once we get set up on the bench. But the cool thing that Gunwerks has figured out, when you do not have the option to be able to use an optic, they now have what they call their Revic XO system. And basically it's like a peep sight with a dial. So they have a particular charge or particular number grains of powder in here. So this one is 100 grains of Blackhorn 209 powder using a specific bullet, which I don't have here with me. I think it's a 330 grain Parker. Don't hold me to that because I don't have it here in my hand, but I'm pretty sure that's what it is. So they've created a load, and based off of that load, they have made basically like a CDS system. So you just dial your yardage. If that elk is out there at 300 yards, you dial to 300, put the peep sight on it, put the post on it, squeeze the trigger, down goes the elk, or so that's how it's supposed to happen. So what I'm going to do, we're here on a range in Texas. I'm gonna set the muzzle loader up. I've already sent a few down just to get a little bit more familiar with it. We feel like we've got it dialed in pretty well. And just to show you how easy it is to use, stand by. Hey, what's up everybody? I'm interrupting my own video here to tell you about a new project that we just completed. If you've ever wondered what we teach at our long range shooting schools, now you can find out 100% free. We have put together a ebook that has 5 shooting tips and 3 bonus hunting tips in an ebook accompanied by additional videos. If you want to get that ebook, I will pin a link to it in the comments below. Make sure you check it out. Back to the regular programming. All right, so on the bullets, I stand corrected. It is by Power Belt, and it is a 330 grain, 50 cal projectile. Here's how easy it is. So you take out your pre-measured Blackhorn 209, grab your funnel, that goes down into the barrel, pour your powder in, make sure you get it all in and don't spill it like I did on the last load, because it will affect your trajectory and your point of impact. So that goes in there, take your bullet, goes right in the tip. Also, I should mention on this particular field to table that we do, our outfitter has purchased a safe full of these particular muzzle loaders. So this is what you will have. You do not have to bring your own. You will have one very similar, if not identical to this. And we will spend time with you on the range showing you how to use it, how to load it. Of course, you're going to have a guide with you, and he will help you throughout the process as well. So then you just take your, got the bullet in, take your ramrod in there, and then you just push it down. You don't have to tap. This has a witness mark, so I know that I'm at the right depth. It's pushed down in there. Pull that out. I am loaded. Obviously, I don't have my primer in there. That is it. So when we go to the bench, I'll get this loaded up. We'll send one down range. All right, so we got it loaded. I now have my primer in. Work the bolt forward just like you would on any other bolt rifle. Safety is exactly the same. So if you're anything like me, you haven't shot with iron sights in quite some time. So getting that consistency like you do with a scope, we're not shooting half MOA groups here. I think I've sent three down and we've made some adjustments on the post itself. But you know, we're shooting at a diamond this big. For an elk, you know, we've got vitals like this are bigger. So anyway, just keep that in mind whenever you're hunting. This is not something, like I said, where you're gonna shoot half minute groups. So I've got two targets on there. I am going to shoot at the left one. I have the Tacticam LR going. You'll see that there's a couple of holes in there. Those are not from a 50 cal muzzleloader. Those are from a 6.5 Creedmoor that I was playing around with earlier, but we're gonna go on that same one. I'm basically too lazy to walk down there to put up a fresh one, so full disclosure. Okay, here we go. We are going center, left target. Spotter, you up?
Spotter's up.
All right, here we go.
All right, our elevation's good. We're a little left.
Just a little left?
We are 4 minutes left.
Oh, wow. Okay, so we need to make another adjustment on the post. I don't think all of that is me. But anyway, like I said, the point of this is just to show you how easy they are. That's how easy it is to load and to get started with it. So we need to get dialed in a little bit. We'll play around a little bit more on the adjustment on this post or in our windage and see if we can get it a little bit closer to center. All right, spotter's up.
Is it ready?
All right, send it when you're ready. Oh, there we go. You are, you're touching the center diamond.
Nice.
Nice. All right.
So,
yeah. So, here real quick what we did, obviously we swapped out shooters, which is a good thing. Steve shoots a whole lot more of everything than I do, but especially iron sights. So we actually didn't change anything other than the shooters. So my pride's a little hurt right at the moment, but I'll get over it. So what we're gonna do is Steve has been working up the ballistics a little bit just to compare it to what we have here on the dials, and everything is really running pretty true. We've got our Garmin here and I've been checking the velocities. And you talk about consistency, holy smokes, it's been, I don't know what the spread is on the last three.
1930, 1943.
Yeah, so very, very good, especially for a muzzle loader. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna load one more. We're gonna go out to 300 yards, let Steve take a crack at it. Just show you guys again, this is not a video on the Gunwerks muzzleloader. Maybe we'll do one later. There's quite a few of them out there. It's fantastic. So if you're considering a high-end muzzleloader, I would recommend it. But anyway, just to show you guys, muzzleloaders aren't that hard. And if you're having trouble getting tags, like a lot of us are, muzzleloader season is one that is easier to get into. So maybe you should consider muzzleloader season, or just come to fill the table with us and get that freezer full. So, all right, we're gonna get set back up and we're gonna go out to 300 yards. All right, we're rolling, spotter's up. Yes, impact, dead center, 1 minute low.
Nice.
Fantastic. So that was really, really cool. And also a really good lesson too. So Steve started plugging everything into our geoballistics app, which is what we use in our long range shooting schools, and using the Garmin as well to be able to catch our velocities. But so here there was a little bit of difference, and it's a good thing that Steve thought to do that. So on the turret, which is cut, like I told you, for a specific grains of powder, a specific bullet weight, and the primer is not really a factor, but it is cut for a 325 grain 50 caliber bullet. We're using 330, so it kind of throws this off a little bit, and we actually ended up being under on our dial just a little bit, and actually he was about a minute low. So Steve, I bet you if you were back on three, probably would have still been dead center.
Pretty close.
Yeah. Yeah, so anyway, it's good to have that data and have that information. But again, the point of the video is just show you how easy it is to utilize a muzzleloader, especially a modern one like this, even if you don't have optics. Steve was able to get on first shot pretty much dead center at 100 yards. It took us two rounds at 300 yards, and he shot this thing three times, and that's it, and got a second round hit at 300 yards without using an optic, just because we had good data. So anyway, these are super simple to use. We will have them available for you to use at our next Field to Table event, which will be 2025. 24 is already sold out. But anyway, we'd love to see you guys on the next one, and we will see you all on the next video.